Hi friends, theory exams are those where we generally cannot score much. In spite of good presentation, neat handwriting, completely writing answers, I mean correct answers, in spite of writing correct answers, still, theory papers are something where we cannot score much. Yes, this is a big misconception and a wrong notion according to me. The reason is very simple. Most of the students, whoever is having this kind of feeling, 99% of the students, whoever is having this kind of feeling, they generally think writing correct answer for a given question is sufficient. They feel writing correct answer in theory exam is sufficient. But remember, it is not that your answer is correct. It is not just your answer is correct. Your answer should also be complete. Example, in my CA IPCC, I remember I wrote auditing for around 70 to 75 marks and I got 57, only by 70 or 75 marks attempting. CA final, I remember very clear, I attempted for around 69 or 70, some 5 to 6 marks question outrightly was wrong, so which means effectively I have attempted for 65, got 59. I'm not joking, I'm serious. If you ask me, so what is that mantra or what is that, technique that I have used to score such a marks, almost, whatever the answer I read, I'll definitely get full marks in theory. There will not be any reduction because I don't just believe in writing correct answer alone. I write complete answer. Matlab, you may get a doubt. So what's the difference between correct answer and complete answer? In fact, many of my students popularly know this. I frequently repeat these two words. It is not which is correct answer that is sufficient, but complete answer is important. To show you the difference between a correct answer and complete answer, I'm making this video. So watch till the end, share it to your friends. Let us overcome that particular misconception and notion and present right your exams upcoming auditing very well. I already made a similar video of this kind 2 months ago. It is already there, but don't know whether have you watched it or not. So once again, I'm doing a fresh video. Right now, I will show you illustration to differentiate between correct answer and complete answer. Suppose you wrote answer correct, but it is not complete. The question carries 4 marks. You wrote correct answer, but it is not complete. You'll get 2.5 marks. You think what? Since I wrote correct answer, you'll get 4 out of 4. But you hardly getting how much? 2 or 2.5. Suppose you write complete answer. Correct and complete. You get 4 out of 4. Sir, understood. First, differentiate between correct and complete answer. Yes. Watch this video till the end. Okay, I'm opening the illustration. Now, question number this one, 12. What is this question reads as auditing? I selected a simple question so that anybody whoever have not yet revised the entire subject also can understand. The first auditor of Healthy Wealthy Limited, a government company, was appointed by Board of Directors. The first auditor of Healthy Wealthy, which is a government company, was appointed by Board of Directors. This is the question. Maybe this question will be extended by 1 or 2 more lines by dates, all that in the exam question paper. Now, how most of the students generally write this answer, you know? Yes, I'll show you right now how generally students write. Students, almost most of the students, they know some particular rules which they have to follow. They start writing provision. So the first auditor, first they write the provision. The first auditor, like how they write, some students may write as per Companies Act. As per Companies Act 2013, the first auditor of a government company shall be appointed by C&AG. If C&AG fails, then Board of Directors will appoint the first auditor of government company. this is how generally students write the provision. Okay, provision is correct. Okay, maybe the students may also write within 60 days from the date of registration. If CNDG fails, board of directors will appoint within next 30 days the first auditor of government company. So days also they'll mention. Agreed. Now, what is the analysis and conclusion that they write? Analysis and conclusion. In the given case, the first auditor of Helly Wealthy Limited was appointed by board of directors, and hence it is invalid. Correct. The answer is correct. Very much correct. I can't object this answer at all. And this question is asked for 4 marks, and the student hardly get 2 or 2.5. Sir, why? What's the reason? That's what, sir. ICA is an institute where they don't award full marks. They don't want a candidate to, get full of the full. They don't like it. Egoist. Wrong. If it is me, or what I suggest to students, when I was a student, how I attempted this answer. If at all the same question comes, how I will write. I'll do a comparison. Okay, fine now. So if it is me, the suggested mode of presentation, see, this answer is correct, but I hardly give how many marks, 2 or 2.5. Why? I'll show you the reason now. If it is me, how I will write. Same. First start with provision. Same approach. Provision, analysis and conclusion. 2-paragraph approach. Provision. As per provisions of Companies Act, if I do not remember the section number, as per provisions of Companies Act 2013, if you remember section number, instead of the word provision, section 139, subsection 7. As per provisions of Companies Act, the first auditor of a government company shall be appointed by CNAG within 60 days from date of registration. If CNDG fails to do so, then board of directors will appoint within next 30 days. Correct until now. But provision is not yet complete. Provision is there still more. If board of directors also fails, you may get a doubt. Sir, they are asking only first part of the provision. No, why you need to write this point also? Section 139 subsection 1 contains this point also. No. How can you write only part of a provision? You have to write full provision. You can't write only part. If board of directors also fails, then members of such government company will appoint the auditor at an extraordinary general meeting within next 60 days. Now you see, what I wrote is provision. You also wrote provision, I also wrote provision, but I wrote complete. Still provision is not complete. The first auditor shall hold the office until conclusion of next AGM. This is the provision. You see, generally what students they write is, they only write relevant part of the provision. See, always know this provision, some people use the word side heading called relevant provision. You should write relevant provision, not relevant part of the provision. You are writing only part of the provision. You are not writing entire provision. Understood? See, what the student wrote here is correct. What I also wrote is correct. But what appears? Completeness. Now, remember, if you are the valuation, will you give more marks for this answer or that answer? Just genuinely think. Obviously to this answer, right? That's what I said. Complete answer. Now, analysis and conclusion. Listen until end. There is one more point. surprise that you have. Okay, analysis and conclusion. In the given case, always remember, whatever the fact which is given in the question, all that facts should come in your analysis. Most of the student, they don't give whatever the facts given in the question in the analysis, they forget. In fact, some student use the side heading called facts of the case, which is irrelevant. You should give facts in the analysis part. In the given case, first describe what happened. First describe what happened, what is there in the question, first mention that. In the given case, the first auditor of Helivelli Limited, a government company, was appointed by board of directors. However, as per Companies Act 2013, or you can write here, as per the above provisions, the first auditor shall be appointed by C&AG. Now you concluded, you gave the fact and you analyzed the fact. Now give your conclusion. Therefore, the appointment by board of directors is invalid. Sorry, excuse for the handwriting. Actually, I'm writing after a long time on the touch screen again. So that's why it is little distant. So I hope you understood the concept. That's enough. Fine. So the appointment by board of directors is invalid. Now this is a complete answer. Again, you should show your smartness here. You just don't write like this answer and leave it. Underline the key points. What is it? As per provisions of Companies Act, the first auditor shall be appointed by C&AG. This you have to underline. Within 60 days, underline that. If C&AG fails, then board of directors will appoint. This is the relevant provision. Write entire provision, underline the relevant point. In the given case, first auditor was appointed by board of directors. Okay. However, as per Companies Act, first auditor shall be appointed by C&AG. Therefore, the appointment is invalid. I hope now everyone understood the difference between a complete answer and correct answer. If you write the answer in this way, now tell me, do you think you'll get 2 out of 4? Definitely not. You'll definitely get 3 or 4. Definitely you'll get full marks. That is my guarantee. In this way, if you write the theory paper, whether it is law or auditing or EAS or SM, giving complete answer. See, don't write as it is. You need not copy-paste answer whatever you read. Am I copy-pasting? No. I'm writing with my own words. But entire concept is conveyed. This will give you full marks. Hope everybody understood. So, in the next video, what are all the points that are relevant day before auditing exam? What are the questions or concepts that you must go through? I'll make another video. I'll upload it. So stay tuned to this channel. All the best. Have a nice day. Bye.